Today we are going to prove a very nice formula for computing the curvature. And this right here is equal to the magnitude of the cross product of V and A, and then we divide this by the magnitude of V, and then we raise that to the third power. Imagine if you have a curve in a 3D space, then this formula is pretty easy to use. And if you have a curve in a plane, then you can check out my other video where I showed you all the formulas you should know for computing the curvature. But let's see why this is true. First, let's begin by making an observation from V cross A. So first thing first, if we just look at this, it doesn't seem like we have a lot of things to work with. But don't worry, because for A, for example, we have done a video on how we can break down A into the tangential component and also the normal component. So let's change that. But since we'll be working with T and N, how about V? Is there anything that we can do? And the answer is yes. Have a look. Let me just put a note on the side real quick. V is equal to the derivative of R with respect to T. And if we just rewrite this as the derivative of R with respect to S first, and then look at S and differentiate that with respect to T because of the chain rule, what's this? This is exactly the T, namely the unit tangent vector. So you can write that, and then this right here, ds dt. So let's just work with T and N, and let's see what will happen. For the first one, we are going to replace this right here. So that is T, and then we multiply that by ds dt. And then we are going to cross this with A, which from last time, we know we can write this as at times t plus an times n. And in fact, we do have formulas for at and an, so let's use that as well. So this right here is equal to t times ds dt, and then we are going to cross that with at. What's that? Well, this right here is just the second derivative of s with respect to time. And then right here, we multiply that by t. And then next, an, there are two formulas I showed you guys last time, right? One of which is the one that does not require curvature. But here we're trying to get a curvature. So we are going to use the one that has the curvature, which says an is equal to the curvature kappa times the first derivative of s with respect to t, and then we square that. This is the second derivative, this is the first derivative s squared. And then of course, we still have the n. Cool. Now, let's just take this and distribute it. Remember, we have to maintain the order of the cross product. Well, technically, right here, it doesn't really matter, you'll see, but I'm still going to maintain the order. Anyway, this, we will multiply with that first. And perhaps I will just write it down as how it is. We will have ds dt, and then we multiply that with d2s dt2. And then we will have t, this t cross this t. But it's going to be zero. And then we are going to add, let's put this multiply with that. So we will have ds dt times the curvature kappa, and then ds dt squared, and then we will take t cross n. Okay, what's t cross t? The answer for that is very nice, right? It's just equal to zero. Any factor cross itself is just going to be zero. So this is the zeroth factor. So this thing doesn't matter. And now how about this? What's t cross n? Well, we have the t, n, b vectors. So we can write this as the unit binormal factor b. So this part doesn't matter. And right here, this is just a regular multiplication. So we can write that as ds dt, and then raised to the third power. And then we have the curvature kappa. And then right here, we have the unit by normal factor. So as you can see, when we do V cross A, this is the result that we have. So that's the inside. And it has the curvature kappa. So what do you think we should do next? Well, just go ahead and take the magnitude of it, right? Now, we will take the magnitude on the left-hand side, and then of course, do the same thing on the right-hand side. Right here, notice ds dt. Let me just make a note real quick. This is just the speed. And we can write that as the magnitude of the velocity. So in fact, we can just write this as the magnitude of the velocity and then raise that to the third power. And then we'll take the magnitude of kappa. Well, that's just going to give us kappa. And here, let's just say kappa is non-negative, okay? And lastly, we just have to take the magnitude of the unit binormal factor. But another note right here, this is a unit factor. Therefore, the magnitude of B is just equal to 1. So this right here doesn't matter. And as we can see, we will have the magnitude of V cross A being equal to the magnitude of V to the third power times kappa. And this right here is just a regular multiplication. Yeah. So finally, you can just divide this on both sides. Therefore, we can see curvature kappa is equal to the magnitude of V cross A, and then divided by the magnitude of V raised to the third power. And that is the formula that will save our life. Well, I don't know.